Did you ever watch the 1998 science fiction disaster film Armageddon? But you would have surely seen the film Deep Impact, right? Well, Hollywood couldn't portray the asteroid impacts exactly, but these films can make your blood run cold. Taking everything into account, getting hit by an asteroid is a bad day for life on Earth. Whether you claim it as part of the natural cycle of living in the dynamic and evolving solar system, it is worse than a massive wildfire or a huge flood. Marauding space rocks fly around outer space, giving no concern for Earth's precious biosphere. If they have got a sight of our Earth, they're going to wallop us, and if you research their mass and speed, they could dominate the Earth powerfully. Hey busybodies, the Tattletalers are back. Welcome to yet another video of Discover X. Looking for something to quench your thirst for mystique? Then, feathered friends, you have perched the right nest. In today's video, we will help you unearth if an asteroid falls in the ocean, will it cause a tsunami? But before we get a grip on the video, don't forget to smash the red subscribe button and hit the notification bell not to miss any content of our channel. Alright, we're back in our argument. The cost of destruction they cause is insignificant when an asteroid hits the Earth and the ocean all the time. It actually goes unnoticed. This mystery is that they're tiny in scale and they get slowed down by the Earth's atmosphere. There's evidence of the downfall of meteorites and asteroids on Earth. Since the water dominates 4/5 of our planet, we can conclude that they have also fallen in the oceans and seas of the Earth. However, the bigger they get, the effects of such an event would be disastrous. But you'll have to stick with more patience to know more about that. Okay, to make a clearer insight, let me develop a few things about these mysterious space rocks. Asteroid bodies are stellate acidophilic inclusion bodies, usually 20 to 30 micrometers in size, with as many as 30 radiate arms found within the cytoplasm of multinucleated giant cells. They are rocky bodies, usually show up in a small size and are inactive. They usually hang around the sun, taking up some weird shapes. They also pop in a spherical shape, such as Sirius, but usually they are in the abstract form. It is said to be that more than 150 asteroids are also known to have a small companion moon. Tons of small particles and dust hit the land now and then. We really don't notice them because of their tiny size, but things can change if the big ones have decided to hit the Earth. Asteroids are leftovers from the formation of our solar system about 4.6 billion years ago. The fall of asteroids in the Earth's ocean has the potential of generating tsunamis of cataclysmic proportions. Just imagine, a car size to hit our Earth. It will turn into a huge fireball that burns up completely before it gets a sight of the Earth's atmosphere. In comparison, the rocks also burn up before reaching up to Earth, creating meager damage. Did you know that every 2,000 years a huge space rock about as big as a football field hits the Earth? Asteroids can cause an immense amount of damage. So, if an asteroid half mile big can charge something on the area of the impact, if it's more than half a mile, the impact would be beyond your wild imagination. Well, that really makes us so curious to know more. We have been struck by asteroids many times. In reality, a civilization-threatening risk from space objects is extremely rare, occurring once every few million years, according to NASA. Well, you must have probably heard of a Burj Khalifa-sized asteroid hitting the Earth. Social media in a buzz, with the news of an enormous asteroid approaching the Earth, with apocalypse-like scenarios being built up. Even though NASA has ruled out such a possibility, the users all went panicking. Okay, what really causes tsunamis? Tsunamis generally occur when large-scale shifts of mass in the seabed, like in a landslide or earthquake, these shifts can cause a huge movement in a massive column of water. This can form wavelengths of 100 kilometers or more from the seabed to the surface. The interesting thing is that tsunamis aren't very dispersive and don't lose their energy as they travel along. So when they reach the coastlines, they destroy everything in their path. Well, I didn't mean the asteroid impact in the middle of an ocean wouldn't be dramatic. It'll cause some damage. A big splash can travel tens of miles away. In addition to this event, an important fraction of the impacting asteroid's kinetic energy will go into vaporizing huge quantities of water. The vaporized water in the atmosphere is a potent and powerful greenhouse gas. So this injects the stratosphere and changes the Earth's climate. Intense shockwaves and strong winds can create havoc on the surface. If an asteroid is to hit the continental shelf of the Maryland coast, it could create 7-meter waves, roughly causing flooding from New York to Georgia that would take hours to recede. The research also suggests a similar impact off the coast of California could flood major power plants along the coast. Around 66 million years ago, you and I or even our granddad would not have seen the world. An asteroid about 9.5 miles in diameter hit the Earth. One of the greatest scars on our planet is hidden beneath the Gulf of Mexico and the Yucatan Peninsula. The crater is buried over 90 miles in diameter, was created when a massive asteroid struck the plain, which brought a calamitous end to the generation of dinosaurs. The immense Chicxulub crater is a remnant of one of the most consequential days in Earth's history of life. This collision caused a ginormous tsunami with waves as tall as 330 feet. Wow! That's just amazing, right? The smaller space rocks, such as the meteor explosion in 2013, blasted through the atmosphere in Chelyabinsk, Russia, which can cause major property damage and crush the Earth. Sohail Ezzedine is an applied mathematician at Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory in California, along with his colleagues, to evaluate the threat of such smaller impacts to US coastlines. They used a computer simulation to imitate how asteroids of about 165 feet, approximately 50 meters in diameter, striking toward the ocean would affect waves. He also illustrated the effects of similar impacts on the West Coast, and the results were pretty unexpected. They found out that it could cause a tsunami with waves as high as 10 feet. Ezzedine says that this is not good news, as there are many power plants of PG&E. But scientists claim the risk of an asteroid-caused tsunami has been overhyped. Such an event was overrated, and studies to claim that these simulators are wrong. A study which is published in the journal Earth and Planetary Sciences found about the Eltonen impact. The Eltonen impact is an asteroid impact in the eastern part of the South Pacific Ocean. It left a huge crater on the ocean floor of the coast of Chile 2.1 million years ago. And according to the findings, it didn't really cause a tsunami. The asteroid had caused this impact was likely 1.5 to 2 kilometers in diameter. It was far larger than the small rocks Ezzedine's team had modeled. Experts ask that if such a massive rock didn't cause problems, it seems even less likely that a relatively meager one could. These simulators showed unrealistic results when the researchers analyzed the simulator more closely. The former models were found to have monster wave heights based on incorrect predictions about how waves break in the ocean. These models can predict wave heights that exceeds the ocean depths, which is a physical impossibility. What can really happen is that a huge wave can form in the area of impact in the ocean, but it can break immediately, which results in very little energy traveling further. An asteroid can impact a point source, and it only influences the region around the impact point. But to create a tsunami, you need something that disturbs the entire water column. Experts claim that an asteroid ocean impact is throwing a rock into a pond. The first thing that you'll notice is the rock releases some energy, causing some small waves to form. But the ripples are dispersive. They lose their energy very quickly. These dispersive waves in an ocean will be very localized and won't have the energy that a tsunami does. NASA and some other organizations are trying to track and distinguish asteroids that could be a potential threat to our planet. So the answer is a no to the question that will cause a tsunami. No documented tsunami has yet to be generated by an asteroid impact. As we said, if it would be there, the impact is wild. That is a wrap to the video. What are your thoughts on this? Are you an astronomer or wishing to be one? We would love to know about that in the comment section below. If you grabbed up something new today, then give this video a like and share. Just click to the left or right hand to get more videos on DiscoverX. Adios, till we see next time.